Obama just went into hiding after it's discovered who he snuck into US to spy on Trump. Liberals are now basking in the glory in their proclamation that they finally found the Trump-Russia collusion bombshell they've been seeking, after information emerged about a meeting that Trump Jr. had with Russian attorney Natalia Veselnitskaya back in June of last year. But unfortunately for liberals, their victory now appears to be short-lived. Through Trump Jr.'s meeting, an incredible dirty bombshell has just been revealed about Obama and his crooked former Attorney General Loretta Lynch that is sending ripples across America's political atmosphere today. What Obama and Lynch did is not only crooked, but a serious federal crime that could have huge implications in the weeks and months to come. Colluding with foreign governments to influence our government is a serious federal offense as spelled out in 18 U.S. Code 2385 that carries a hefty penalty of 20 years in prison. But as liberals continue to try and prove that the Trump administration was guilty of collusion, all they've done is turn the gun on themselves, proving that they've been the ones colluding with the Russians this entire freaking time. According to breaking reports, we are now learning that Obama and Lynch were secretly colluding with Veselnitskaya for months and that the meeting she had with Trump Jr. was a complete setup. Shockingly, Obama's Justice Department went through illegal loopholes in order to bring the Russian lawyer to the United States in the first place, after the Moscow lawyer had repeatedly been turned down for a visa to enter our country lawfully. But being a major pawn in Obama's sabotage against Trump, Veselnitskaya was allowed to come to America under extremely extraordinary circumstances. Obama and Lynch's current cover story for colluding with this Russian lawyer was for the purpose of helping a company owned by Russian businessman Denis Katsev, her client, defend itself against a Justice Department asset forfeiture case in federal court in New York City, Dennis Michael Lynch reported. But Obama and Lynch's cover story is just a smokescreen, as it's now being proven that Veselnitskaya was an Obama plant who then went on to conduct non-official business and lure Donald Trump Jr. into a private meeting which liberals are now using as a basis for getting President Trump impeached. Dennis Michael Lynch has more on this breaking scandal. According to officials, Lynch granted her approval for the limited purpose of helping a company owned by Russian businessman Denis Katsev, her client, defend itself against a Justice Department asset forfeiture case in federal court in New York City. Veselnitskaya then used the U.S. immigration system to enter the country and engage in non-official business. Such business included her meeting with Donald Trump Jr., former Trump campaign chairman Paul Manafort, and now White House senior advisor Jared Kushner in New York City last June. 5 days after that meeting, Veselnitskaya was captured on video, sitting in the front row at a House Foreign Affairs Committee hearing on Russia policy. Veselnitskaya was also seen at a movie screening at the Newseum in Washington, D.C. The film questioned the Magnitsky Act, which imposes sanctions against Russia for violations of human and political rights and is opposed by Russian President Vladimir Putin. Veselnitskaya appeared at a Capitol Hill dinner where Representative Dana Rauchhabacher, Republican California, and approximately 20 other guests discussed the film and Russian policy. On Wednesday, Rauchhabacher said he believed Veselnitskaya was there to lobby other legislators about reversing the law so Americans would again be allowed to adopt Russian children. Predictably, liberals are trying to pin blame on Republicans for Trump Jr.'s meeting, alleging that Veselnitskaya was requested by Republican Senator Chuck Grassley of Iowa to enter the untied states, which is a complete fat freaking lie. Grassley, who chairs the Senate Judiciary Committee, immediately defended himself against the ridiculous allegations, where he sent a letter to Trump administration officials and Homeland Security Secretary officials asking why Veselnitskaya was permitted to remain in the country by Obama and Lynch when she was required to leave back in 2016 before the meeting with Trump Jr. even took place. While liberals are proclaiming victory at this point, there's much more than meets the eye when it comes to Obama and Lynch's intimate ties with Russian lawyer Natalia Veselnitskaya. As previously stated above, colluding with foreign governments is a federal crime, and randomly requesting a meeting with Trump Jr. before the election just simply doesn't add up. This woman is obviously a plant, and as liberals keep pushing to prove the narrative of a Trump-Russia collusion conspiracy, they're simply digging their graves deeper, as they'll be forced at some point to answer why they were working with this Russian and went through illegal loopholes to bring her to America in the first place. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe Breaking News 365 channel. Goodbye and see you again.